Yeah, problems like this for OneDrive syncing, it's a common problem, along with some other things that happen with OneDrive, and I'll show you how you can fix them. Here are the steps I go through to fix these common OneDrive sync issues. The first step, hover over this and see what it says. Notice it says syncing files, one remaining. So there's one file that it's having problems with. Right click. If there's a problem with syncing, you'll get a View Sync Problems menu option. And in this case, it's not there. So we know we have one file, so you just got to take a look at that file and figure out what's going on. So from the menu, pick Open Your OneDrive for Business folder. And look down the list for a non-checked green box. And you can see right here, this projects folder is not synced properly. Open it up and look for the file that's not synced. And you can see right here, this 2018 project list document file is not syncing. So the quickest solution I usually do is take this file and drag it out onto your desktop. Make sure it's removed from the list. OneDrive will attempt to resync the file. Now take a look at your OneDrive, and you'll see that it's no longer having problems syncing. In this situation, we can take that file and drag it back in here again, and it will resync, and the problem's been resolved. Locating this file, you'll see now that it's got a green check mark. If View Sync Problem shows up on your menu, it's usually because you violated one of these file and folder limitations. You can't sync individual files over 15 gigabytes. The maximum file name is 400 characters. You can't use any of these invalid characters. You also can't use these file names. And you can't use these names for folders. Also, be aware that if you go over 100,000 files, you'll start to see some serious performance issues with synchronization. And finally, with OneDrive for Business, each user is limited to 1 terabyte total storage. If you've attempted to remove the file and restore it back to the OneDrive location, and you've also corrected any view sync problems, but you still have issues with the syncing on OneDrive, another option you can try that I've found to be successful is to repair your Office installation. Go to the Control Panel, go into Programs and Features, find your Microsoft Office 365, click the Change button, and do a quick repair. Click the repair option. It will close you out of all of your Microsoft Office applications and run a repair. When it's done repairing, check it out and see if it works. Another item to check that can affect the synchronization is Windows updates. Make sure you don't have any pending updates or updates that are requiring a restart, like is what's showing here, because that can interfere with the synchronization process. If you've exhausted other options and you still have issues with syncing, you may need to stop and rerun the syncing process, which I can show you right here. Right-click on OneDrive, choose Stop Syncing a Folder, click the Stop Syncing, and hit Yes. Hit OK, and it will stop syncing. Now, before you resync, it's a good idea to go to your C drive and take a look at your Users folder, and go into your particular user account, you'll notice that there's a OneDrive and a OneDrive for Business unsync changes, sometimes multiple. Take a look inside there and see if there's any files that haven't been synced. If there are none, I prefer to actually remove these folders and let it recreate it when it syncs up again. You can also see your OneDrive file location and all the folders. It might be beneficial to move these files out of the OneDrive sync location, run the synchronization so it's very quick, and then copy the files back once it's done. So I'm going to select all the files, move them out onto my desktop or some other location. Now again, I'm going to right-click, sync a new library, and it should come up with the options to sync to your folder. Occasionally, this will not actually come up with a location, and then you may need to go back and do the repair of your Office install again before you actually do the synchronization. But in this case, I'm going to sync now. It prompts me for my contact information. I'm going to choose a work or school account and log in just like I do in Office 365 and sign in. It begins to sync the files, and you can click the button to show the location of where they're stored. You'll notice that it's turning the green check mark on for those folders that it's syncing. And it's added a 1 at the end of the folder name to separate it from the original one that I synced before. You'll notice both listed here. To see the status of the synchronization, you can come down to the OneDrive and see that it has 161 remaining. Once that's complete, you should see the green check mark there and nothing left remaining on your OneDrive syncing. Now you can compare the files in here with what you've moved out of the old location if you want to just double check to make sure nothing's lost. And you can clear the OneDrive original location now that it's empty and unneeded. And hopefully one of these solutions has worked for you to clear up your OneDrive syncing problems. If you have any issues, please comment. I'll be happy to respond to any of your questions. Thanks for watching. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.